tell us about the deal now. Online betting is growing so fast, so why make this deal right now?
Well, I mean, let's be honest. We use this term best in class, and DraftKings is definitely best in class. They're a tech company. We're a bricks and sticks company, and this is a great opportunity for them to come into Fertitta Entertainment and pick up all of our databases from the Houston Rockets, from Landry's, from the Golden Nuggets 24 Karat, from Select Club. And it's good for us, too, because we're going to take their customers and they're going to be able to use their points and be part of our ecosystem. But for us, they're the leader. They're the best at this. They have a strong balance sheet. Yep. There's going to be a few survivors in this. And there's a reason their name's DraftKings. They're going to be the king of sports and iGaming. They're the best at sports betting. We have a great platform of iGaming, so combining the two is going to make it really special. And there's a reason I wanted it to be an all-stock deal.
Tilman, in some ways you've come across to this deal the kind of the long way around, i.e. via a SPAC. Were there any talks before the SPAC deal was done? Why is it kind of happening the way that it's happened?
Well, you got to remember, you know, a lot has happened in the last 18 months. I mean, Golden Nugget Online Gaming was a little piece of my huge company doing $20, $25 million in EBITDA. And it was spun out during the pandemic. And, you know, here we are today selling it, you know, for a huge amount of money because we've all realized the value of online gaming and sports betting online, which continues to get approved in new states, you know, continuously. This is going to be a huge part of the American economy is online sports betting and gaming in the years to come. And there's going to be a lot of consolidation in it. There's going to be a lot of players in it, just like every industry that ever happened in the beginning. And we felt like DraftKings is the best from a technology standpoint, a management standpoint. Jason has an unbelievable team that he's put together. And this isn't what we do. And I felt like, why shouldn't I ride their horse and take their stock at the same time? But we can help them by building more Golden Nugget casinos around the country.
But why not do this a little while ago? Why go via the SPAC? When did the conversation start? I'm just kind of curious as to how the whole process happened. You obviously saw the value in this asset, and you clearly like what is happening with DraftKings. Why not go direct?
Because we did not. This all happened so quick. Everybody forgets that this was not a huge industry. Everybody has to remember where even DraftKings was a year and a half ago and 2 years ago as a company, and where we were as a company a year and a half and 2 years ago. We never had talks. We didn't know where this industry was going. None of us, not DraftKings, not us. This is all something new in this America.
So, Tilman, talk about something new. COVID and then now the Delta variant. If we had had this conversation a few months ago, it would have been a little bit different. But now, how are you dealing with the Delta variant within all your businesses in terms of vaccination requirements, mask mandates, return to office, return to work? Can you walk us through your thinking? What are you noticing? What are you seeing? How do you feel about stuff?
Well, I mean, you know, this is unbelievable. And remember, we're only on D, the Delta. There's a lot of letters in the alphabet. You know, today, you know, our office is operating. All of our industry is operating, and the casinos, employees are wearing masks. Louisiana and Nevada are making customers wear masks. We're having our employees wear masks everywhere. And hopefully this, what happens here is what happened in India and Great Britain, is the fact that it has a quick pop coming out of the 4th of July, and then it dies. But this is something we're going to deal with. It is not having a huge effect on business whatsoever. But the one business that will thrive if this does happen is the online gaming and online sports betting. So it helped us when this was the only business we had that was open at one point. And so it was a huge positive for us. But hopefully this is a little bump in the road, and we'll all get through it.
Yeah, agreed. I think we're all on board with that. I did want to ask, though, about any sort of pushback in terms of people coming into casinos and asking them to be vaccinated. Like here in New York, for example, restaurants, you have to have a vaccination passport to eat indoors. What are you noticing in terms of that?
So far, only New York has done it. You know, I don't agree with it. I'm going to make my little hostess the vaccine police. You know, I wish everybody would get vaccinated so we wouldn't have to deal with this. I wish there was a way that we could plead with all these Americans that have it. I personally can't understand why somebody will not get vaccinated. And, you know, that's one of our things in our company is push our employees and push our customers to get vaccinated.
Tilman, in 20 seconds, any shortage of labor right now?
Continues to be a shortage of labor, which is almost unbelievable with unemployment still where it is. But that's what happens when you throw money after money after money in the economy. And we continue to do it with one stimulus package after the other. But I'm not going to complain because a lot of that money is coming to my casinos and restaurants and my online gaming. So if the government wants to keep putting money in everybody's pockets, we'll be glad to take our little piece of the pie.